Now we're ready to learn how to handle transactions with late paying tenants. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Usually tenants stay before they pay, but some tenants pay late and some don't pay at all. But you still earn the rent as long as they stayed there and you're entitled to record earned income. Now your invoice can be a request for payment because now you're asking the tenant to pay after they used the service that you gave. Money we may receive from late paying tenants is not unearned. Therefore, the invoices we made for late paying tenants should not affect the unearned income account. But unfortunately, in QuickBooks Online, they will. And that's because QuickBooks Online allows you to add an additional account receivable type of account to the chart of accounts, but for some reason it does not let you use it. It only allows you to use one account receivable account in the whole QBO account. Or at least that's the way it's been from 2013 to 2019, the day I'm making this video. So we have to adjust for this if we're using this as a landlord. So what do we do? Well, we should just be aware that if we have late paying tenants, unearned rental income is somewhat understated. Most people only have some late paying tenants and they're only late for a little while. But if it's a lot, you might have to look a little deeper to find out the amount that it's understated. Now don't worry, it's only off until reporting time. So it's not a big deal that one number is a little off until it's time to show your numbers to an outside source. And we can easily find this amount and adjust for it. And once we adjust for it, we can record our invoices for late payers normally. That's what we actually do. We first record the invoices the same way that we record the invoices for rent earned for people who pay early or on time, and then we wait until the end of the period and adjust. The following video after this one will show the adjustment when it's time to report, and it will be very, very easy. So, for example, let's imagine on January 1, we called and received acknowledgement from Betty that she did stay for the month of January. Therefore, we earned and are entitled to January's rent from Betty. We will make an invoice that records the rent earned and the money owed to us from Betty. So this is how we do it. Just like we did before, no different. We click the plus sign for all transactions. We click invoice in the last column. Now, of course, the date is January 31 because that's the date that we really earned the January rent. And the tenant is Betty, indented under 2B. Now, I happen to remember, well, we have to click under product and service for the arrow. Click on the arrow to click rent due. And in Betty's case, the amount is $1,000. So we're going to click save and new. Or save and close. We'll click save and close to close the window. And now after we come back to the dashboard, let's take a look at the reports. Click report, trial balance, and you can see that rental income earned increased, but which is correct. And if we double click, we can see that it should have increased by the amount of the invoice for Betty because we really did earn it. Unfortunately, if we click report, But unfortunately, if we go back, we can see that unearned rental income decreased for the invoice for Betty, which is here, January 31. You could see that this is Betty. You could click here, could stretch this a little wider. or you should be able to anyway. But the point is, you can see this was the invoice we just made for Betty, and it did decrease, unfortunately, the balance of unearned rental income, even though it shouldn't. But don't worry, in the video that follows this one, we'll fix it. But click reports and go back to the tenant balance detail. And when you click, you can see that Betty Boop has a $1,000 balance, and the number is positive. And the reason the number is positive is because Betty owes us. Remember, QuickBooks is meant for a normal business where the customer usually owes the company, not vice versa. So in this case, it's a normal balance, but not normal for landlord. So she owes us this $1,000, whereas we owe Candy $5,000 in future rent services, and we owe Alan $10,000 in future rent services. Now let's solidify this with a second example. On January 31, we called and received acknowledgement from Dave Deeney that he did stay for the month of January. Therefore, we earned and are entitled to January's rent from Dave. We'll make an invoice that records the rent earned and the money owed to us from Dave. Okay, and here we go. Very simple. Plus sign, invoice. Okay, computer remembers within this session is January 31. The tenant is Dave Deeney. Careful how you click. Click for the product and service. It's rent due, and Dave's rent is $1,000. Okay, now save and close. Okay, and again, when we click reports, trial balance, you can see rental income earned is accurate. Unearned rental income is not accurate. It's understated, because the amount that it's understated is really owed to us, and this is really the net amount. And again, we're going to adjust. Okay, now let's if we look at the individual tenant records, you can see the tenant balance detail now includes a transaction and a balance for Dave in 4D. Where is it, Dave? His is a positive $1,000, which means he owes it to us. And of course, the report that doesn't help at this point, but will help in a moment, is the transaction list by tenant. You can see both Betty and Dave only have one transaction. So let's do example three. Let's make the February 28 invoice for all tenants, and let's take a look at how that would look on the reports. Well, very simple. You can click the plus sign, and we can make these very quick. Invoice, keep the date just move the date actually to February 28th. Alan is the only one, where is it? Alan is the only one whose rent due is $2,000, so we'll make his first. And instead of clicking save and close, you can just click save and new, and that saves the window and keeps it open. Okay, now we have to, I thought it would keep the date at February 28th, and it didn't. So now we'll do Betty, and I happen to remember for February, because this is Betty's February, it's her second invoice, it's $1,000 for her, save and new. Oh, good, it kept the date, so now we can do Candy Charles. And I happen to remember she's $1,000. You could always pause the video if I'm going too quickly. And of course, February 4, Dave Deeney. Is also $1,000. And now things will be more clear on the customer reports. So the best report is really the custom report that we made, tenant balance detail. And when we go to the tenant balance detail, we can see the changing balance, and you can see that the late payers have a negative balance And the early payers, or the payers in advance, oh, excuse me, the late payers have a positive balance. The amount that Betty owes us as of March 28th, as of the date we earned the February rent, February 28th actually, is $2,000. We owe Candy $4,000 as of that date. Okay, Dave owes us $2,000 and we owe Alan $8,000 in future rent services. Now, this is really the best report. It's not perfect, but it's the best report for tenants' details, transaction by transaction, and what the balance was or is. Now, what we need to do is collapse this report so that we can easily see the total negative and the total positive. Once we know the total negative, we'll know the amount that your accountant has to adjust the receivables account with a simple, normal, periodic adjustment. And again, you only have to make that adjustment if you have to stop and report your numbers to an outside source. So here's what to do. Collapse each of the apartment names, 2B, 3C, 4D, A1, it's supposed to be 1A, that's why it's out of order. But anyway, notice it'll clearly show you who has a positive balance and who has a negative balance. So if you don't have that many tenants, or you don't have that many tenants with a positive balance, just be aware that the total of the positive balance is the amount that you have to adjust unearned rent for. Unearned rent income. In fact, the total of the positive balance, when you add all the positive numbers together, that's the total that unearned is understated. So what are the numbers? Well, we know the net amount from the report is $8,000. That means that there's $8,000 more that people paid in advance than will pay later. So of the net amount, though, unearned is really $12,000, and that's the amount that has to show up on your financial statements when you report your numbers. And rent receivable is really $4,000. So what you'll have to do is just be aware that this $8,000 consists of $12,000 of advance payers and $4,000 of late payers. And when it's time to report your numbers to the IRS or to some other organization, your accountant will make a simple, normal accountant adjustment, usually a journal entry, but only an accountant can make this journal entry to make unearned the correct number and rent receivable the correct number. Except for this, 100% of your reports and 100% of all the transactions that you enter are exactly correct, and this method works perfectly for landlords.